Is it worth running macOS 13 Ventura on an unsupported Mac Pro? That's the question everyone asks, and so I decided to make two videos. This first one is about the cheese grater, the Mac Pro 4.1 or 5.1, and the next one will be about the trash can, the Mac Pro 2013. So if you haven't yet, I would recommend you subscribe to the channel and click the bell for notifications so you don't miss a new video and you don't miss the ultimate Mac Pro guide, which will be released afterwards with benchmarks, comparisons, and the big question, is it still worth paying money for those Mac Pros? 2 weeks ago, I asked the question in my last video, is macOS Ventura 13.3 and OpenCore Legacy Patch 0.6.2 the holy grail for Mac Pro users to be able to use Ventura without any big issues? Due to the support of the community, and thank you so much for all your comments, all your insights, problems and solutions and hints, and with my own findings on my Mac Pro, I can say it is maybe not. The reason for that is, at first, and that is what I already told you in the other videos, to install Ventura, you need USB wired mouse and keyboard. Why is that? Because Apple dropped support of the USB 1.1 drivers. And these basic input devices, for instance, use USB 1.1. But there is one more, that is the Bluetooth controller. Without Bluetooth, no wireless mouse or keyboard, and so you cannot install Ventura with your wireless mouse and keyboard. And when you try to plug a regular USB keyboard in, it won't work either. The reason is the USB 1.1 controller, there are also no drivers anymore. But first, let's thank our sponsor for this video, and that is UPDF from SuperAce. You all might know Adobe Acrobat for handling PDF files, but there's another way more complete and way more cheaper solution, that is UPDF. With your one account, you get access to every platform like macOS, Windows, iOS, and Android. And you can do everything you have to do with a PDF. Edit, merge, fill out forms, shrink the sizes, and so on. But there are some features that even Adobe Acrobat doesn't have. For instance, you can create a slideshow out of your PDF file, and you can export your PDF into different picture formats. And if you click on the link on the video description, there you get an exclusive 54% of your purchase that you can either have an annual plan or a one-time fee to handle all your PDF needs. The trick that the developers also wrote on their website is to put a USB 2.0 hub in between your Mac Pro and your mouse and keyboard. And that is one of the good things of the Mighty keyboard. It has an integrated USB 2.0 hub and two ports, so if you plug this into your Mac Pro, it will detect it as a USB 2.0 device, and it will automatically use the USB 2.0 controller, which is still supported. If you have your USB keyboard and mouse and your USB 2.0 hub, and you've got Ventura installed, and then you do the post-install root patch to have the graphics acceleration, everything seems fine. Until you do one thing that the Mac Pro is meant for, in my opinion, you plug in extension cards. And one of the most common cards that users plug into their Mac Pro 2012 is the USB 3.0 card, like this one here. It has some USB 3.0 A and C ports, and it's plugged in into one of the PCI Express ports. As soon as you plug this in, your Mac Pro won't boot anymore. It gets kernel panicked and it won't boot. And the reason for that is written on one of Dortania's websites, that the USB 1.1 drivers, they were able to re-implement into Ventura to get your Bluetooth working again, right? And your USB mouse and keyboard, they can't be mixed with the USB 3.0 controller. Otherwise, there will be a kernel panic. When you use Ventura on your Mac Pro, you have to decide, do you use Bluetooth for whatever devices you need Bluetooth, at least for your wireless mouse and keyboard, or do you use a USB 3.0? If not, you are stuck to USB 2.0 that the Mac Pro has. Maybe if you use FireWire or other expansion cards, they work, and you don't need USB 3.0, that might be one of the options that you can go with Ventura. Another thing that came up is Ventura 13.3, where Apple dropped support for a lot of graphic drivers that the developers were able to re-implement as well. I just again installed macOS 13.2.1 and 13.3 and did a comparison. There is no difference if you use 13.3 with the latest legacy patcher and they add the graphic drivers, or if you use 13.2.1. The other things I tested was Apple TV, Netflix, the weather app, AirDrop, but unfortunately, on my Mac Pro, and even though I have an upgraded Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module, AirDrop only works that I send maybe a file from my phone to my Mac Pro. That works, but not the other way around, because the Mac Pro doesn't find my phone on AirDrop. Give me your comments if that works with your Mac Pro with Ventura. All other features I could test do work, except USB 3, because I really like to have my Bluetooth and my wireless mouse and keyboard. Next video will be about the Mac Pro 2013. That one doesn't have the issue with the USB 1.1 because it has an upgraded USB routing, and the USB 1.1 issue is only for 2012 and older. And by the way, there's no port where you could plug in a USB 3.0 card, and it already has USB 3.0. And let's talk about Ventura on a Mac Pro 2013 and how and if you can connect an eGPU, an external GPU, via the Thunderbolt ports to accelerate the graphics, because the internal Fire Pro graphic cards from 2013, they don't have graphic acceleration. Thank you again so much for your support. Give me your feedback in the comments. Maybe subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet and click the bell for notification, and stay tuned for the next video about the Mac Pro 2013. See you soon. Bye bye.